Infection control is a critical aspect of healthcare and other settings where there is a risk of spreading germs and bacteria. Disinfection and sterilization are two important procedures used in infection control to reduce the risk of infection. Both involve the use of chemicals or physical methods to kill or remove microorganisms, but there are important differences between the two. This video breaks down a sample TMC practice question on this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. A BiPAP machine that was used in the emergency department has been returned for cleaning. Which of the following agents would you recommend for surface disinfection? A. Ethylene oxide. B. 70% ethyl alcohol. C. Alkaline glutaraldehyde. Or D. Acetic acid. Do you know the correct answer? Well, let's break it down. To get this one correct, you needed to know which substance in the answer choices can be used as a disinfectant. The first answer choice, ethylene oxide, is used for sterilization in heat or moisture-sensitive items, such as plastics and respiratory care equipment. We're looking for a method of disinfection, not sterilization. So we can rule out A because we know that it's not the correct answer. Alkaline glutaraldehyde is used for high-level disinfection and sterilization and requires the object to be submerged in the solution for a period of time. This is not possible with a BiPAP machine, therefore we can rule out C as well. Acetic acid is a disinfectant, however, it is typically recommended for use in a patient's home, not in the hospital, which means that we can rule out the answer choice D. Now remember, alcohol-based solutions are typically used to disinfect surfaces in the hospital setting. Therefore, that is what's recommended to clean the surface of a BiPAP machine, which should be performed before use on a new patient. And that means that the correct answer has to be B, 70% ethyl alcohol. If you enjoy practice questions like this, definitely consider checking out our TMC test bank. It's a massive bank of practice questions with helpful explanations like this one that students are using to pass the TMC exam. It also comes with 4+ sample TMC practice exams to help you test your knowledge and prepare for the real thing. If you're interested, I'll drop a link below this video if you want to learn more, including some helpful premium bonuses that are only included for a limited time. But if you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.